welcome those of you that watched Purdue and Maryland in a great game in College Park. Corey Provost alongside John Crispin here tonight from Rosemont, Illinois, the Allstate Arena, Illinois and Northwestern, as we look at the starting lineups. And John, you look at the Wildcats and change. Jordan Ash and Aaron Falzone in. Scotty Lindsey, Gavin Skelly on the bench.
Well, look, Chris Collins said you got to find the guys that are going to compete, and you got to reward the guys that will do so, and that's exactly what you're seeing tonight.
Michael Finke coming off a struggle. Last time out, jumps for Illinois. The opening tap controlled by the Illini, underway here in Rosemont.
I don't want to say it's a contrast to two styles, but the Illini will play so up-tempo. You may see some of that. You may see some turnovers, but the up-tempo style versus Northwestern, who's going to want to control the game, especially in the half court.
Talented freshman Mark Smith walking, and turnovers a problem for the Illini last time out in a 7-point loss at Wake Forest. Turned it over 19 times. Also committed 24 fouls in that game.
Well, Corey, it takes time to get comfortable playing fast. You know, you have to make decisions fast, and that often leads to turnovers and some defensive breakdowns that give Vic Law an open three.
36% three-point shooter Vic Law, the first field goal tonight. Dijon Lucas driving. Here's the freshman Smith. Can he answer? Yes.
That is a guy that you cannot lose. And I understand you're going to switch around the perimeter, but you still have to identify shooters. Don't overhelp and give up an open three for a knockdown shooter like Mark Smith.
Reigning Mr. Basketball here in the state of Illinois. Law. Vic Law averaging 13 per game. Had a 30-point game against Creighton not long ago. And a good start for the redshirt junior.
Now, key for Northwestern, this sounds kind of ridiculous, but getting some made baskets. Made baskets are going to be easier to defend in the half court as opposed to playing that up-tempo, up-and-down-the-floor style of play that Illinois wants to play.
McIntosh up the floor, finds foul zone. And an offensive foul is called. It'll be whistled on Falzone. Smith on the receiving end, drawing the contact, and Falzone picks up the first. Falzone starting, along with Jordan Ash. Chris Collins going with the group that really battled, despite the loss, the one-point loss at Georgia Tech earlier in the week. Finke. Illinois needs him. Coming off a rough game. Black, the offensive rebound, tied up. The floater short. And Jordan Ash the rebound. Getting back to Jordan Ash, starting here tonight. His first collegiate start. He's a junior from Bolingbrook, Illinois.
Pressure out on the perimeter, just taking away reversal passes. And that's what leads to a tough miss like that. You take the reversal pass away, you're taking away everything that the coaches and the team wants to do.
There is Chris Collins in his fifth year, 77-63, telling us before the game, look, based on last year, reaching the NCAA tournament, bullseye is on his back and the players' backs, they all know that, and at times, haven't handled that all that well.
The bullseye is not there just because they made the NCAA tournament. The bullseye is there because they're good. This is a team that started in the top 25 when this season tipped off. So you have to have that expectation, but the issue is the intensity has to match your level of expectation. So far, it hasn't.
Defensively, Chris Collins telling us before the game it's been better the last two games. Overall, the struggle this season. Good pass, better block, and they will whistle a foul, I believe, on Smith, and it will be a foul on the freshman.
Let's take a look at it. I'm always an expert after I see it twice. Yeah, he might have gotten him on the follow through, but I think he got ball first.
That's his second foul, too, John. So two quick fouls just more than 2 minutes into this game. And the freshman will indeed come out.
And that's something that Brad Underwood talked about. We have to learn how to play fast, play up-tempo basketball offensively and defensively, but without fouling. Pick a lot of chippy fouls up in the backcourt.
So Aaron Jordan checks in. Aaron Jordan off the bench. What a story. Top three-point shooter in the country right now at 66%. He's made 19. There is Jordan, the junior from Plainfield, Illinois. So he's made 19 threes in seven games. Last year in 24 games, he made six all season.
He's getting good looks.
When you play with tempo and pace, you get defense chasing the play. When you get defense chasing the play, you get open shots. It's that easy, Corey.
That easy. Simple. Shot clock under 10. Here's the aforementioned Jordan in traffic. And one.
And Eric Jordan just goes right at Scotty Lindsey. He's able to rip through and get past the defender. And look, it's not bad defense, but he's making it a point to attack Scotty Lindsey off the bounce. And that just puts Derek Pardon in a bad position where he's either got to get a block or probably foul.
First foul on Pardon. So Jordan completes the three-point play. And with subs coming in for Illinois, Kipper Nichols checks in without the white headband here tonight. And Ron Black departs. First Big Ten game for Brad Underwood. As this Illinois offense averaging nearly 87 points per game. That's the third highest number in the Big Ten so far this season.
He is the alpha dog of all alpha dogs in the conference, right? I mean, you just see there's a way he carries himself. It's not, you know, everybody uses the word swagger, but he is an intense guy. He brings that out of his team. And his kids respond to him. So far, they have really responded well to Brad Underwood and the messaging that is, this is our new identity.
It's an up-tempo offense. They look to score within the first 7 seconds of each possession. Skelly in for Northwestern.
Everybody's looking to score within the first 7 seconds if you can get an easy basket, but they're actually trying to create opportunities with their defense to score quickly.
Good defense there from Finke. And the miss from Skelly along the baseline. Here's that tempo. Dijon Lucas got a tug of the jersey of Law and got away with it. Allsorg inside with cutting Nichols, and that will not count. A foul. They're going to get Skelly before the shot. But getting back to Brad Underwood, John, and the tempo that they want to play at. You see, third highest scoring team of the Big Ten, 76 possessions per game. That leads all Big Ten teams.
Well, and I know a lot of people out there saying, well, who have you played yet? Yes, you're right. They have to do that against Big Ten competition, but that possessions per game are probably going to continue to go up. And when possessions go up, there's less pressure on each shot down the floor, so I think the scoring can continue to rise. Not to mention, teams enjoy playing that way. If you play up tempo, you get easily get sucked into it. That's something that happened to Northwestern here against Creighton. They got sucked into the tempo of the game, and that just favored Creighton.
Shapal Sells from nearby Wisconsin originally. Great crew here tonight. Paul Sells, Terry Weimer, and DJ Carstensen, and they're taking a look at the shot clock here right now. And trying to bring it back down to 19. So Brad Underwood wondering what happened, and now they're going to shift it from 19 back to 20.
Corey, you are just at another level. When you hit Paul Sells, you know, hometown, do you have his stats per game, too, somewhere?
Sun Prairie, Wisconsin,
dude,
to be exact.
You did some homework for this game.
He's a baseball fan. He's had to talk some baseball on some. 1 point game under 10 to shoot. Eric Benson in for the Illini, 25 in white. Now defending Finke. Nichols the rebound, and he is fouled on the floor.
It's amazing how you talk about rebounding, and yes, you want to say box out, but you got to be in position first. And there was a miscommunication on a switch there. Finke got the shot. Barrett Benson was just out of position. And that's how you end up picking up that foul.
Benson 6'10", but size inside, that's not a strength for this Northwestern team.
Well, it's not a strength really for either team. I mean, neither team has much in the front court outside of, you know, Michael Finke, LeBron Black, but they're not your typical bangers down low.
McIntosh, quiet start so far for the senior. Skelly lost it off his leg. Allstork feeding Jordan. And a foul. He was going to hammer that one down, but Scotty Lindsey on defense. No dunk. Instead, two free throws and we come back. It's a 1 point game early on at BTN. 1 point game early on here on BTN. Northwestern 7, Illinois 6. 15:52 to play here in the opening half. With that, we welcome you courtside, everybody, with John Crispin. I'm Corey Provis. Look, Northwestern coming off that NCAA tournament season a year ago. ranked to begin the year, but a 4-3 start, surprising many. What about you? Did you see Northwestern being 4-3?
Yeah, the expectation was so high because of the NCAA tournament run, but the intensity, the sense of urgency has not been there, and that's been the issue. And it was there last year because there was a collective goal. It was everybody as a team, everybody as a unit is working towards one common goal. That was the NCAA tournament. Well, what's your common goal going to be this year? And you have to eliminate the me and find a way to make it more about us. Got to feel like Tony Robbins. I'm going to start charging for that.
I know. That's good. Illinois with the lead by one as Jordan makes two and the first lead tonight for the Illini.
I like the pace of the Illini, and I think it's going to wear on a guy like Bryant McIntosh, much as I think of him. That's a lot of work. I mean, just having to get the ball up the court, it's not just physically exhausting. You can't say enough about that. It's mentally exhausting because you're constantly having to make decisions, and he hasn't even been able to make a pass yet.
McIntosh so good at going left. That one rattled out, and the rebound comes down to Williams. Lucas in transition. With the roll, Tijon Lucas. Averaging 5 per game, Illinois by 3.
Great defense turns into a runout, and you have a Northwestern team just not able to get back and get set.
7-0 Illinois run, and a whistle away from the ball, and a foul will be called on the Illini. Well, tomorrow on BTN, Penn State and Iowa square off, and the conference opener for both teams, Big Ten basketball, tomorrow, 5 Eastern, right here on BTN and streaming live at BTN to go on Fox Sports Gold. Benson comes out, Pardon back in. Skelly comes out as well. Jordan Ash back on the floor. There is Derek Pardon, junior from Cleveland.
Corey, it's interesting. I mean, I just finished my last bit of leftovers of turkey, and we're already watching conference basketball. I mean, seriously. I think it's great, but I know for the coaches, this is a challenge. You use November and December to get yourselves ready for conference play. Brings a whole new sense of urgency to December 1st.
Belzone off the fake. That's short, and Devontae Williams the rebound. He played against his dad. Sorry. Frank Williams, great player. And now LeRon Black with a walk.
His dad played against me. How about that?
That's right. Sorry, let me rephrase. That's right.
Could not be further from the truth, Corey. That man beat us up. I say that about a lot of people, I think. And I don't mean to sound self-deprecating. I finally grew up and became honest and realistic with my abilities.
McIntosh, one shot attempt so far tonight. And this will go the other way. And they're going to whistle an illegal screen on Falzone.
I want to figure out, we should take a look at how many dribbles McIntosh has had as opposed to passes and shot attempts. And he's really being forced to dribble the basketball. And yeah, it's probably an illegal screen. It's very close, too wide of a base, maybe a little chest lean. But the issue is Bryant McIntosh is being pressured and they're trying to help him out.
Belzone now with 2 fouls, so he comes out. So here's Devontae Williams. Illinois by 3, and he throws it away. Picked off by Skelly. McIntosh, the floater.
God, that's good. That's just good. That's not an easy shot. I don't care what level you're at, there are NBA players that respect that shot.
LeRon Black for 3. That's a part of his game. That's his 3rd made 3 in 6 attempts all year. Illinois made 12 threes despite the loss in Wake Forest. Bulk of those threes came early in the game. McIntosh thought he was fouled. No whistle. Freshman Trent Frazier against Skelly. Bumped. Left-hand shot. No. And a foul. And they're going to call it, I believe, on the floor before the shot as we go back to this a moment ago.
Corey, you got to look at this. Look at the amount of dribbles this is taking Bryant McIntosh. He can't make a pass, and he's forced to take a tough shot. If that's how it's going to be in the half court, he's going to have to take advantage of some opportunities in transition where he's got space. And that's going to be a challenge for Bryant McIntosh. He's working hard on both ends.
So McIntosh will sit. Foul on Skelly, by the way. He has 2. Belzone has 2. And of course, Mark Smith, freshman for Illinois, picked up 2 fouls about 2 minutes into the game.
again, the tempo and pace does more to you than you realize. You do pick up fouls. Why? Because you're chasing the play. You're behind the play. And to catch up, you end up fouling. Plays at the rim are always fouls when you're a step behind the play. It's one of the keys for a guy like Reggie Lynch and Derek Pardon. If you want to stay on the floor and be a shot blocker, you have to be ahead of the play. You have to be at the rim before the ball gets there.
Ball on Ron Black. That's his first. Team fouls mounting. Kipper Nichols returns, and speaking of LeRon Black, he will depart. LeRon Black has upped his scoring this season. Lob inside. That's well defended by the Illini. Williams, though, but he's on the baseline. Well, Illinois saw that pass coming to John.
Well, look, that's coaching. I mean, yes, it's instinctual play, but let's take a look at it. Oh, wow, that is so close. I don't know if he... It looks like he was. Look how close that is. Oh, I'm so glad I'm not a ref. Official, formally.
Stay with Northwestern. Here's Kipper Nichols, redshirt sophomore from Cleveland.
I mean, that is C-man, C-ball. Understand your position in the defense. These are principles that Brad Underwood's teaching. If you can develop yourselves to be an up-tempo team, both offensively and defensively, but be a lockdown defensive team in the half court, that's a dangerous team.
Anthony Gaines on the floor for the first time for Northwestern as a freshman. Long! And a great finish with the right hand. Good start tonight for Vic Law. He has 7 of Northwestern's 11. Into the corner with 7 to shoot. Now Finke. It's Williams off the fake with 4. Spinning, no, and Law clears. The lead for Lindsey. Now Stork the rebound. There was contact. Play continues. Williams got the roll. Lindsey was getting back and missed the block. And Devontae Williams scores off the glass.
All right, Chris Collins is yelling, get back. I mean, there's no excuse for giving up a layup in that situation. It was a baseline rebound. It's not a runout. That's the sense of urgency that I think has been lacking for Northwestern.
Scotty Lindsey, too, John, missing his first shot. Scoreless the other night against Georgia Tech. His first scoreless game since his sophomore year. But he sticks with it here, and he's fouled on the putback. As we go back to Vic Long, low to go.
If there's space and there's a breakdown defensively because you don't have anybody there to protect the rim, Michael Finke just loses sight of the ball. But this is after a baseline rebound off of 3, and you're giving up a wide-open layup. Those are the things that are inexcusable when you're watching film.
Ball is on All-Stork, his first. So 2 free throws here for Scotty Lindsey. Mentioned that he was scoreless the other night, the 1-point loss against Georgia Tech. It was 0 for 8 from the field, 0 of 5 from 3 as Jordan Nash comes out.
But you've got to find a way to get to the foul line. You've got to find a way to get to the basket. If you're struggling shooting the basketball, this coming from somebody who just took threes all the time, but you understand with that type of length, Scotty Lindsey's got to be cerebral in his approach. If he's not making shots, find opportunities, because it's not just about you scoring and getting yours. It's about doing what your team needs you to do. Just make some shots.
And the fact that Northwestern lost that game by 1 when Lindsey and Falzone are combined 1 for 16 is amazing, only losing by 1. Nichols pretty.
And yeah, Chris Collins said that would have been a great one to get considering played really good defense. And if you win a game like that ugly, it makes you get even more confidence in that defense. Takes a little bit of the pressure off the offensive side of the ball.
Illinois has 6 field goals from 6 different guys. Lindsey, too strong. Pardon's put back. Fell out, and Finke clears.
I will say, Illinois is getting away with a lot of hands on the ball handling. It's something that they've tried to talk about, clearing up, freedom to move, and all that stuff. Making it really difficult to get to the basket cleanly.
Nichols over Pardon. And a whistle, and this will go the other way, and a foul will be called on Illinois. So we will step aside. It's a four-point game. In the house here tonight, Northwestern head football coach Pat Fitzgerald saving his son, saving a Illinois player. A timeout. You in part by State Farm. Here to help life go right. Look at the Big Ten Conference office, not far from where we are here. Near Chicago's O'Hare Airport. And speaking of the Big Ten, a lot of eyes on basketball tonight and certainly football tomorrow. And tomorrow at 3 Eastern, BTN Tailgate comes to you from Indy. 2 hours of Wisconsin, Ohio State pregame coverage. Then when the game is over, get thorough analysis on the championship postgame show. It's all tomorrow right here on BTN. Pat Fitzgerald would love to have his team in that championship game one day. Off the inbounds pass to steal and a bucket for Tijon Lucas. And Chris Collins calls a timeout. He is livid right now with his team. Lucas, the bucket, and the Northwestern head coach. Look at the fire out of the Northwestern fifth-year head coach right there, John.
He's not livid with his guards. He's livid with his big guys who just stood at half court and didn't come back and help. You've got to get back into the play. You know you're facing pressure, and you can't expect your guards to do everything throughout the entire course of the game. And Derek Pardon's got to come back quicker. And he just stood back and watched, and at some point, you have to make yourself available top of your screen. It can't be last-ditch effort with 4 seconds into the inbounds. You've got to make yourself available to at least alleviate that pressure. Not to mention, if Derek Pardon comes up, gets a catch, Bryant McIntosh can turn and be off running.
Now, for this Northwestern team and ranked to begin the season, they bring back a ton of talent, but they are missing a couple of guys. Nathan Taphorn, good three-point shooter last year, but maybe the loss of Sanjay Lumpkin is something that will be big throughout the season, don't you think?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, that was the alpha dog. And it's not just what he does on the court, it's what he does in the locker room, and can't say enough about that.
Good long, good game here tonight. He has 9, John.
It's a made basket, but it's another made basket that's not an assist. And I think that's going to be something we've got to follow, is not a lot of the baskets the Northwestern are going to get and have gotten are coming off of an assisted play. It's not a driving kick. It's not creating an opportunity. It's just creating a play.
Finke in the corner. The three-point shooter last year. Can't connect that time, and now McIntosh. Lindsey. Over Black, it's short. And the rebound comes down to the freshman, Anthony Gaines.
Anthony Gaines is a guy Chris Collins has a lot of confidence in. He says he's going to be a really good player. He's just not there yet.
Oh, there's that lane, and he goes over Finke and a charge. The man bun. And position, and Law whistled for the foul.
I don't know. The man bun's dropped a little bit. Wow, that's close. That's really close. I don't think there's any way Vic Law is going to dunk that. You get a better look at it here. Well, he's out of the lane. It's bang, bang. I hate that call, though. I almost think you should just take the charge out of basketball. You're not allowed to take charges. It's impossible for officials to get right all the time. And you're not actually stopping the play. You're just getting in the way. And I know it's a dumb thing to say. I just don't like it.
As a shooter, an offensive-minded player. And the basket will count, and they're going to call a foul on Anthony Gaines. But the basket will count.
Look, the foul is on Anthony Gaines, and it's a foul. But it's a foul because this Illini team is attacking in every way. I mean, the shot goes up, and they're attacking the glass. And that's where there's a foul on Frank Williams. Anthony Gaines committed against Williams.
Anthony Gaines, the foul, he comes out. Haven't seen Isaiah Brown yet for Northwestern, and Brown, a sophomore guard. He's been slowed all season long by a quad injury.
Just the intensity so far has to be matched by Northwestern. And I think it's got to be matched on the defensive end. I mean, offensively, they're going to eventually come into their own. They've got too many weapons, too many playmakers, guys that can create for themselves and for others. Defensively, you've got to win your battle. You've got to get your man off the glass, and you got to keep your man out of the paint when they're trying to drive. Win your battle.
You know, McIntosh, 1 of 3 so far tonight. Is Illinois not letting him shoot? Is he not a factor because of the way Illinois is defending?
Well, absolutely. I mean, they're taking everything away, including easy passes. Reversal passes are not there. I mean, even that right there, that's an exchange.
but they are right on him on the exchange.
Lindsay stripped but fouled.
It's been impressive, I've got to say. I think Northwestern's in first gear right now, and they've just got to find a way to get out of gear and get moving forward. But Illinois has nothing to lose at this point. They're building. They're trying to find their identity. And so far, this team seems to be responding very well to Brad Underwood.
Mark Smith coming back in, two fouls. Demonte Williams going out, picked up his second.
I like giving a guy a chance with two fouls, especially if you have a chance at a dead ball, put him back in on offense. I like giving a guy a chance to see if I can trust him down the road. You've got to earn the trust. To earn trust, you've got to be given opportunities.
Even a true freshman,
yeah,
you're okay with that?
Give him opportunities to either screw up or do a great job.
Scotty Lindsay, good free throw shooter.
Says the guy that doesn't coach, hasn't coached, and wouldn't lose his job if a team lost, right? I do. I think you've got to give guys opportunities to earn more trust. Doesn't mean you don't start that way.
All score. And over back. Had a chance to keep it in the front court, but then as he kept on surging to the half court line, an extra.
Yeah. That's the fumble that the big guy tries to pick up and run into the end zone. He's got a fall on it. Pick it up.
Allstork, the only player that Illinois will not have back next season. He's a graduate senior transfer from Wright State. Averaged 19 points per game in the Horizon League last year.
I would have said on that dead ball, I probably would have gotten Mark Smith out.
McIntosh, his best look tonight. And Lucas the rebound. McIntosh, 2 points and 1-4 shooting. And a traveling violation on the Rod Black. The sixth Illinois turnover.
That's the type of possession, if you're watching film, you're Northwestern, you can go back to and say, this is what we're looking for. Crowding the ball, rotating, communicating, being tough defensively, protecting the basket. Those are the things that you've got to build upon. It's there. I mean, this is an experienced team.
Lindsay over Smith and those two fouls.
He's got to be strong. You're going against a guy who's much shorter and has two fouls. There's no reason not to just be patient and go and attack.
Scotty Lindsay, 4 points off the free throw line. 0-5 from the field tonight. That's a poor pass from Nichols, but bailed out by a whistle. Now McIntosh defending on Allstork, but that was not a great entry pass. Still a foul called on Northwestern.
It's like pass interference when you've got your arm on the back of the guy's jersey. Vic Wall had his right arm, if you watch it. I think it's soft, but he's got his right arm on him. Yeah, that's weak. Love how I'm trying to sell something, and then I see the replay and realize how wrong I was.
It's Vic Law second. So you look up and down the roster on both sides. Law's got two. Skelly's got two. Valzone has two for Northwestern. Then for Illinois, Mark Smith has two fouls, and Demonte Williams has two fouls.
Well, I still think a lot of that has to do with the tempo and the pace. You're trying to constantly catch up with the play, and that puts you in a bad situation. Playing against some up-tempo style play, whether it be on the offense or defense ring, you've got to take a second and just play position basketball. Don't move too much and don't move too fast. Just get set, play position basketball.
McIntosh got his defender up, left it short, and Nichols the rebound. Try to go behind the back, it was knocked away by Lindsay. Katosh in traffic. He had it poked away. Now Lindsay with 17 shoot.
I feel like you're going to say that a lot. Yeah, McIntosh in traffic. I mean, the traffic's been there because the defense has been where they needed to be.
Foul on Aaron Jordan. And that's his first. We have a timeout. 8 point. Only meeting this season between two longtime rivals, Northwestern and Illinois. But starting next season, when the conference schedule shifts from 18 to 20 games, this is a protected rivalry. Yep. Western Illinois will play twice every year. Same for Michigan, Michigan State, Purdue, and Indiana. We'll all play home and homes beginning next season when the conference schedule moves to 20 games. When the action ends, Joe takes over. Highlights from around the conference, post-game reaction straight from the arena, and in-depth expert analysis. The Big Show presented by Valvoline. After the game right here on BTN.
I think Robbie Humble's in there tonight. He can fix all the things that I messed up today.
Robbie's there with Rick Pizzo coming up at the half.
I think at some point, if you're Northwestern, you have to start to back cut this pressure. Alleviate the pressure, keep the defense honest by at least attempting some back cuts. Even if the back cuts are not for a score, the back cuts are to keep the defense honest, keep them from playing over top and taking passes away. Because this Northwestern team needs to be able to move the basketball to get into their continuity. Second chance points, there you go, you got to finish.
Harden couldn't do that, and Finke the rebound. Northwestern has made 7 free throws. They've only made 5 field goals. 5 of 19 now from the field.
This is where I think they can be effective. This zone can be effective against the Illini, at least just taking some of the pace out of the game. But you've got to be able to get a stop. You cannot allow an easy basket, and then Illinois sets up the pressure.
Allstork, he doesn't see the clock. He's got one, and the Illini don't get it off. Allstork had it outside the lane, but Johnny had no idea the shot clock was under 5.
Yeah, that's something that drives coaches crazy. It absolutely drives coaches crazy. If you do not get a shot up at the rim, it is a wasted possession, especially in a time when Northwestern was in zone and really didn't have to work that hard.
8th Illinois turnover, and Vic Law has been the story.
Well, Vic Law's a guy that if you pressure too much, he's going to go to the basket. He also can do that.
Can't hit over Nichols. Finke, another rebound.
Look how quickly Illinois gets the ball before. Good transition defense from Northwestern on that possession.
There's that 7 seconds, right, that Illinois was looking to attack, but now Illinois has slowed things down, knowing that Northwestern got back defensively.
That's a problem in the game, and part of the problem is that's a great find. Part of the problem is when the shot goes in, the amount of time that goes off the clock from when you get the ball, take it out of bounds, and walk it up the court and actually run some sort of semblance of an offense. It's just dead time. And half the time, it's 10 to 15 seconds before you really get into it. What Brad Underwood's trying to do is put pressure on the opponent the second a basket goes through for them. You know, Northwestern scores right away. They're pushing the ball off the floor. And that puts a pressure on you that affects both sides of the floor.
Meanwhile, developing story right there. Mentioned how Vic Law has been the story for Northwestern, John. Now 3 fouls. He talked about trusting guys earlier. 3 fouls, 6-12 to go in the first half. He has to sit, right?
Absolutely. He's got to sit. That's one where if you get beat, you may have to just give up the layup. But you can't give up the next 6 minutes with Vic Law on the bench.
See Chris Collins and the foul trouble that a few of his guys have. Law 3, Skelly 2, foul zone 2, and Skelly did not start tonight. Foul zone did. Jordan Ash starting tonight. Scotty Lindsey coming off the bench. Western changing its starting lineup for the first time all season here tonight.
It's not just about changing the lineup. McIntosh just puts his head down. That's probably what he's got to do to alleviate some of this pressure. The issue is Northwestern's got a space. You cannot crowd the lane if the defense is going to pressure 25 feet from the basket. You've got to create some driving lanes and take advantage of it.
Foul on Tijon Lucas, his first. So here's McIntosh, who hasn't missed at the free throw line all year. 19 of 19.
I was going to say, he's probably going to miss that. I was like,
well, there's foul zone back in with 2 fouls. So, you know, he's now 20 of 20 at the line. And Northwestern's record for most consecutive free throws made is 37. That was set by Michael Thompson back in 2011.
I thought it was Sean Morris.
And now the McIntosh family is going to send me all the hate mail.
Unbelievable.
He made 20 in a row, and then we brought it up, Mr. Crispin.
Hey, I really want to get to this. I'd really like to talk about this free throw streak and screw it up for everybody. That was my impersonation of you.
That was great, man.
That was pretty good. Pretty
Lucas, good. Like Crispin with that spin, but couldn't hit. And Jordan foul zone. The rebound, last touch by Jordan.
Let's see this. Oh, that's off of foul zone.
That's off foul zone.
It's off of foul zone.
Yeah. McIntosh. 3 points, 1 of 5 from the field so far.
Oh, what just happened?
See, Illinois players fell down, but Lindsey still struggling from the field.
He got a good look. Kind of a broken play with the defense falling down, but I think it's an important possession not to get a quick shot if you're Northwestern, but to work the defense, make them do something.
Lindsey was 0 for 8 against Georgia Tech. So far tonight, he's 0 of 6 from the field. Lucas cut off by Pardon. He'll stay with the Illini, 8 to shoot and 5-1 to play.
And what a good defense does is not just stop the action that your offense has. You know, it doesn't just stop. If you run the flex, it doesn't just stop that flex cut. What it does is it makes you uncomfortable. It takes away what you like to do, takes away your tendencies. And right now, the Illini are taking away any sort of options in terms of ball movement around the perimeter. We're forcing Northwestern to be a one-on-one basketball team.
See Isaiah Brown for the first time, sophomore from Seattle, check in. That's too strong, and fouls on the rebound. Northwestern without a field goal last 5:45 of game action. Can Falzone change that? Yes.
And that was good action. That was good action. You understand if you're Brian McIntosh, they are going to key on you off the ball screen. Well, if it's going to be with Brian McIntosh now, Falzone, they're not going to leave him.
Nichols fell down, and a turnover. Brown back to foul zone, opposite side. And now Lucas McIntosh back defensively. And a whistle. It won't count. Offensive foul. Lucas whistled for the charge. It was taken by McIntosh. Second on Tijon Lucas, sophomore from Milwaukee.
All right, McIntosh just reads it well, takes it on the chest in position. The no call in that situation, but what the heck do I know? I can't tell with everybody booing. Where are we? Is this a Northwestern home game or is this an Illini home game? I credit the fans for coming out.
Now, this is a Northwestern home game, and the only meeting, as I mentioned, Northwestern not playing on campus this season due to a big-time renovation going on at Walsh Ryan Arena, more than $100 million. That'll be ready for next season, so 1 year Northwestern playing here in Rosemont. Lindsey, two-point game. The lob inside to Laron Black. Well designed and well executed by the Illini.
Yeah, two things wrong. Well executed by the Illini, but two things, no ball pressure, and then just a miscommunication. If you're switching, you've got to communicate even more.
McIntosh. As Northwestern made a rally against Georgia Tech, McIntosh attacking left side of the lane. That was a constant sight. Back to a two-point game. Pardon the rebound. Fell zone. And he walked. Basket won't count. And we have a timeout here in Rosemont.
Foul zone walked on that play, but set it up perfectly. Ball screen opportunity. He picks and pops. And on the other end, things have really cleaned up on the offensive end. You gotta like the action. Northwestern still down two.
Time for a look now at our State Farm assist of the game. A couple of looks, John. Mark Allstork feeding Laron Black a moment ago.
Look, you know it's a great execution of the play when the defense starts looking around, pointing fingers, hands up in the air like, what just happened? Breakdown in communication leads to a wide open dunk opportunity. Look, this game has really picked up. Sloppy as can be. I thought we were excited about Big Ten play being here. Well, both teams get this one combined for 17 field goals, 17 turnovers, 21 fouls. Knock them down, drag them out. Not exactly midseason form, but we'll get there.
The conference play beginning a tad earlier this season. That's because the Big Ten tournament, John, will be a week earlier. And MSG coming up in 2018. So with that, teams are playing two conference games on the earlier side. We'll have a week. Some teams may have 2 weeks off between that and the NCAA tournament if they get there. This will go the other way. A foul will be whistled on Trent Frazier. freshman for Illinois. State Farm halftime report coming up. Rick Pizzo, Robbie Hummel in our BTN studio in Chicago, prepping for that. Purdue beating Maryland earlier tonight here on BTN, 80-75. Isaac Haas at 21. Dakota Mathias at 20. Anthony Cowan at 20. Kevin Herter at 19. You like Maryland, though, don't you?
I really like Maryland. I do. I think we're trying to figure out who four through whatever is going to be in this conference, because I think the top three are set with Purdue, Minnesota, and Michigan State, obviously. But I think Maryland's right there. I think it's right there. And it's just a matter of them coming together defensively. I think offensively they're going to be a very good team. I like Purdue, too. And I think one of the key components of Purdue is Matt Harms. Shot blocking shots. You take Isaac Haas out of the game, you think you're going to go get something in the paint, good luck. Second best shot blocker out there. And he claps every time he does it. It's hilarious.
The one-point game, seven to shoot. And a whistle and a foul with four to go. And Illinois did really not have much going on that possession. Isaiah Brown, the sophomore, whistled for the foul. That's his first. Free throws upcoming here for Aaron Jordan. Maybe two the rest of the way for both teams. Jordan 76% at the line. Averaging 13 points per game. Tremendous three-point shooter this season. As we mentioned earlier, top three-point shooter in the country entering this one tonight. And he had that label coming out of high school. Plainfield, Illinois. At a Plainfield East High School. A great shooter. Really emerged, has emerged so far early this season.
Shooting the basketball at this level is as much mental as it is anything else. Yeah, it's repetition, it's stroke, it's, oh, look, his form's great. Well, that's all great, but if you're not confident shooting the basketball, you don't feel good about the shots you're getting, you're not going to shoot a high percentage.
McIntosh, good look from the wing, off the foul zone pass, and we're tied at 30.
I can't imagine Illinois is going to stick with that zone too much. I mean, that zone just got carved up, and the defense has been fantastic in terms of the man-to-man.
McIntosh now with 8 points. Cutting inside, Allstork. Tough angle. He got away with a shove as Isaiah Brown looked like he got elbowed in the chest.
Yeah, it was a little dramatic. Isaiah Brown was a little, I think if he wasn't so dramatic about the flop, it probably would have been an offensive foul, because to me it was a clear offensive foul. He extended his arm and everything.
Lindsay, there's contact. This will go the other way.
That's tough. That's tough. You don't get it on this end. I mean, Allstark gets away with one, but again, it was a little too much of an act job. Nothing egregious, but you can probably give it to him, and then let's see if this one was worse. Oh, that's just a flop. Lottie Devots is smiling, smoking a cigarette, and enjoying that one. See, kids today don't even know who Lottie Devots is. I'm not that old.
Second foul on Scotty Lindsay. Seconds to go in the half. Black against Pardon. Does it go? The tip will count for Finke. Yes, it will. No, they're going to wave it off now. Terry Weimer saying it will not count. And right now they're going to whistle the foul on Finke. Excuse me, I just saw the numbers. Terry Weimer saying Finke will be whistled for the foul. Red Underwood saying, count the basket, and they're saying no.
They're going to call Finke on the push. Yeah, it's a forearm. Terry Weimer probably, it's tough when everybody in the paint just looks around and goes, I didn't do it. Hands up in the air. Terry Weimer saw the upper body of Aaron Falzone come forward and probably was a clear foul.
Been 25 fouls called combined in this first half. As Paul Sells and Terry Weimer chat.
I'm so excited. We have Big Ten Conference play. It's December 1st. I mean, usually the Hallmark Christmas movies are over by the time conference play starts up. I still got one dialed up for after the game.
Now the teams will huddle up as the conversation continues, and now they're going to bring in DJ Carstensen. This to me looks like, you know, Terry Weimer saw it one way and Paul Sells saw it another way. And they're trying now to debate one another to see, well, this is my view, this was my view, and now maybe to get a third party. And we'll see. They look like they will head over to the scorer's table.
I wouldn't be surprised if they called two fouls. I mean, who knows?
Now, you cannot go to the video monitor to determine whether a violation occurred. That is not a reviewable play. And as we look at, the coach has got to discuss things. Let's go back to the play a moment ago.
Yeah, this is where the foul was called. It's going to be Finke with the elbow on, leaning in. And that's how he gets position. Look, it's a shove. That's a foul.
Now, you can go to the monitor to determine who the foul was on. So are they dead set that it was on Finke or someone else?
That foul was on Finke. I mean, there's not many buns out there. That was pretty obvious who that foul was on.
And we're getting word that they are trying to find out who the foul was on. So Terry Weimer first had Finke.
If that's the foul that he called, yes, it was clearly on Michael Finke. There's a lot of battling down in the paint. I just love this. Foul has definitely confirmed it was on Michael Finke. This is where it's going to be, you know, bottom right of your screen, right of the basket on your screen. And it's just the push. It's the upper body push, and that's why he got position. Aaron Falzone was in position for that reason. Rebound. This is a good basketball game.
State Farm halftime report coming up. Rick and Robbie standing by with that. One-point game. It's been ugly at times here, but still competitive in this first half. Zone. Tie things up at 32 with a minute to play.
If you want to win in the Big Ten, you're going to have to win some ugly games. I mean, teams do a good job of taking you out of what you want to do, and you're going to have to grind out victories.
Foul trouble and issue on both sides. Vic Law with three fouls. Frazier can't hit. Allstork flying in for the rebound. Saved it, but a foul will be called on Northwestern, and they're going to whistle Anthony Gaines with a shove inside.
For Anthony Gaines, you have to be aware of a shot going up. That's why you got to see man see ball. See man see ball is not just being able to take a pass away. It's when a shot goes up, you know to get your body into your man and keep him off the offensive glass. Rebounding is not just done by boxing out anymore. It's being in position first.
Second foul on Gaines. And two free throws here for All-Star. Let's go back to the foul of the goal.
Shot goes up. You've got to go out, find your man. Don't just turn to the basket. You might have gotten away with that in high school when you're more athletic and physically superior than everybody else, but not at this level.
Switch. Williams now picking up McIntosh, and McIntosh stepped on the sideline. Ninth Northwestern turnover.
There's an intensity to this game. There really is. There's an intensity to this game, and I'm watching Mark Allstort. This is a guy who's just not afraid to put his body into somebody. It just feels like midseason form already. Maybe not in execution, but at least in intensity.
Illinois calling a timeout with 35.9 to play here in the first half as we look at LeRon Black so far tonight.
Us, the guy, has really expanded his basketball game. He's done it by knocking down perimeter shots, but he's also much more patient than he's been in the past. Usually just catches looking to make something happen. He's letting the defense move. He's making reads, and he's getting easy opportunities for himself and also for his teammates.
LeRon Black has upped his scoring this year. Michael Finke has upped his scoring. And in the post-Malcolm Hill era, it's a must, right?
Yeah, you're filling a lot of holes when you lose Malcolm Hill. That's a guy that played 1 through 5 for this team. He did whatever his team needed. And with, you know, Brad Underwood here, it's a different identity. You kind of have to get set in who you are for this team in terms of defensively.
what position you are, what you're defending, and then how you're going to be on the offensive end. It's a completely different team. It's not just post Malcolm Hill era.
John Lucas, two fouls. He's been on the bench now for a while. So Trent Frazier running point with 20 seconds to play as All-Star. Works around Ash. Contact with Playon and scores.
I said it just a few minutes ago. Just his physicality. Not afraid to mix it up. He went in, took the contact, kept his eyes up, and finished.
All-Star with eight. Foul zone to the corner for three. Frazier the rebound. Lets it fly. Three quarters court. And it was online and just got a piece of the net. With that, though, we are at the break here at Allstate Arena. It's a four-point game at the break. 36-32 in favor of the Illini. Stay tuned to State Farm Halftime Report coming up on BTN. We are just about ready for the start of the second half. Wonderful halftime show a moment ago here at the Allstate Arena. It's a four-point game at the break here on BTN. Welcome back to the Allstate Arena, everybody, with John Crispin. I'm Corey Provis. A four-point game, as I mentioned, Northwestern, despite some sluggish play at times. Vic Law, 9 points, some foul trouble, but not a bad half for Vic Law either.
Yeah, foul trouble's the issue, and it's been the issue for the entire Northwestern Wildcats team, but it's been because of the tempo of the Illini. Vic Law kept him in this game early. He really did. He made some tough shots. He created opportunities for himself, and that's great defense by Allstort, but it's just a better offense in this one. What did Rick Pizzo say? The one-handed thunder chunky? How do you come up with stuff like that? Not that creative.
Well, the guy who came up with the Midwestern Cowboy.
That's
right?
Fantastic. You know? That's good. I mean, I was hoping at some point I would have a nickname by now. I've been around long enough, Rick Pizzo.
He's listening, and right now that mind is working.
Yeah, but I just hope it's something cool and glowing. Because how I think in my head is not really all the same to everybody else.
Now, some comparable numbers in the first half. Both teams, same number of field goals made, turnovers. 26 combined fouls called in the first half.
Yeah, I think a lot of that, again, has to do with the tempo. It's an intense game. It's a rivalry. This is the first game in Big Ten Conference play. Nobody wants to start 0-1. And remember, this is a Northwestern team that goes down to Purdue on Sunday. I'll be down there for that one. Matthew's been a fantastic place for basketball.
Scotty Lindsey does start the second half, not start the game. Hardy gets it inside and scores.
That's the first time, really in a while, that we've seen offense executed and run for Northwestern, because the Illini have done such a good job of taking passes away and making everything difficult. And back to this, I think this zone may be the key for Northwestern's success in this second half.
Harden active now defensively. The swipe, and here's Law. Deflected, Lindsey for three, and the lead.
Three is huge, but it also allows them to get back, get set. Takes all the pace out of the game. Illinois wants to play with pace. They want to move the basketball. They want to attack. And playing zone forces them to pass the ball around the perimeter and just changes it to play the way Northwestern wants to play.
First lead since the 17-minute mark. Mark Smith, the freshman, a quiet first half. He was sidelined. Foul trouble early. Laron Black, can he answer? For now, no. Finke battling inside, and he'll be whistled for a foul. Fouls own head position.
It also helps for Northwestern. Obviously, you got foul trouble. It keeps guys in position. The biggest challenge in the zone, you don't realize this, the biggest challenge is rebounding defensively in a zone, because you're not matched up with a man per se. You have to be aware of where everybody's at, especially those guys that are going to be crashing the offensive glass.
Second foul on Finke. McIntosh at 8 points in the first half. The lob, Vic Law! Northwestern again going inside. A nice surge to begin this half for the Wildcats. Illinois against the zone. Lucas with five. Around McIntosh. Bothered by Pardon. Got a piece of it. And now McIntosh on the push. Lindsey. That doesn't go. Pardon taps it to Black.
Chris Collins is saying, just get back.
rebound. You might as well just get back, get your defense set. You start to dictate the tempo and pace of this game.
Smith, great find to Black. He walks.
You start to extend the defense out. It's a bit of a breakdown defensively. Vic Lall just reads the play. Back screen, no communication from LaRon Black, and it's an easy dunk. You at least got a chest up. Take away that backdoor lob opportunity or called out early enough. Truth be told, if you're in position defensively, you're not even able to get screened because you're so far over. Help side, no reason to be hugged up on your man.
Red Underwood taking Mark Smith out. Aaron Jordan back in. Lindsay spinning, reversing. Harden couldn't hang on to it. Trapped in the corner, and it'll belong to Northwestern.
You know, Northwestern has certainly fought back. They fought back. They look like they're playing with more intensity, but so much of that comes from the defensive end. They're able to do what they want to do defensively, which is take the air out of the ball. It's not Northwestern wants to play slow. That's not who they are. But in this case, they don't want to play with the tempo that Illinois wants to play with. They need to be able to dictate the tempo and pace of this game. And the zone's helping.
First half, Northwestern had three assists the entire half. So far this half, they have three alone.
Look at this defense. That's tough.
McIntosh splitting, kicking for three in the corner. Allstorf the rebound. Where does Illinois go for offense right now, John?
Depends what you're going against. You're going against the zone here. You've got to get it inside of the zone. I know they say just pass it to the high post. Well, easier said than done. You need to put a playmaker in the high post.
Williams can't hit. Long rebound. Run down by Finke.
I think I would try to run LaRon Black to the high post. Get him in a position where he can make a play. Don't keep him on the baseline. But you've got to cut against the zone. There it is. Attack. You can't just stand and expect to make passes. You're not going against a bunch of six-foot slow guys. Look, this is a Northwestern team with great length. And if you look at the teams that are good in the zone defensively, they've got great length. So they're taking passes away with their length. You've got to cut it up. You've got to carve up the zone just like you're playing against a man.
Bell zone's third foul. Red Underwood's team this half, 0-3 from the field. Two turnovers. They haven't scored yet. Nichols tracks it down. Allstorf left open for three. Had a great look, and LaRon Black active inside. Over Pardon, arcing shot falls.
That's a tough shot. Tough shot, but again, rebounding in the zone defensively is not that easy. You've got to identify rebounders and keep them off the glass.
Tosh, a deep three, short. Lucas the rebound. One on three. Tayshaun Lucas off the glass, and the Illini regain the lead.
That was like a Euro step square, man. That thing was serious. He covered a lot of ground in two steps.
Tayshaun Lucas, not much of a score, has that mindset of a pass first point guard. McIntosh off the fingertips of Lindsay, out of bounds. It'll belong to the Illini.
In transition, this is something that these guys practice. Here it is. One, two. You know what? That was actually a travel. What am I talking about? Eurostep travel. Sunday on BTN, catch a triple header, a conference action as Purdue hosts Northwestern. I'll be there. Minnesota takes on Rutgers, and Maryland squares off with Illinois. It all starts off with a tip-off show Sunday right here on BTN and streaming live on the BTN To Go app as well as Fox Sports Go. Look at that.
Look at that.
That's Greek for John Rocks reading promos. Neprimi.
Neprimi. There's your nickname.
Latin. Neprimi.
There you go, Mr. Pizzo. There's the start.
I did have it. When I was at UCLA, they called me Milk, and I don't know why. I only drink milk with Oreos.
What was your brother's nickname?
Better at basketball than me.
LaRon Black. Solid half so far, adding to it. Black with 11.
I like this. This is getting interesting here.
mean, you got to remember, this is a rivalry game. I checked into the hotel out here by the airport in Rosemont or wherever I'm at, and there's a billboard sign right next to Allstate Arena off the freeway for the Illini. It's Illinois basketball right at the home arena, temporary arena, with Welsh Ryan being under construction or renovation, whatever you want to call it. I just think that's great. Man, I got some tweets. He said, well, our state, our school. And they said, well, Chicago's Big Ten team's nothing. It's our state. I love it. It's great.
This is the only meeting this season between these two. Illinois won both last year. Black can't hit the three, and McIntosh the rebound. Big Law. That's a two. The putbacks, Gavin Skelly.
Transition threes, and it's not just the ones that go in. When you take that shot, it forces the defense to defend the second you get the ball. Not only that, you have guys in position to rebound because the defense isn't set.
There's points for Gavin Skelly, senior from Westlake, Ohio. Mark Smith back of the floor. With five to shoot. Against Law. Can he shoot over him? Yes!
I would give a guy, if I have a guy like Mark Smith, a jump shooter, I would say take a step-back jumper to the left any chance you get. That step-back jumper to the left for a right-handed shooter, your shooting pocket is already there. You're already square to the basket.
Lindsey, great look off the feed from McIntosh. That tied at 44.
Yeah, Brian McIntosh pulling on the jersey.
Oh, LaRon Black was there but could not hang on to the rebound. It'll go Northwestern's way.
Look, it's going to be tough sledding, especially against this zone. And LaRon Black breaks a second-chance opportunity. And that thing is an inch away from being blocked, but he gets it to go. And there he is, just working hard. Taking the hit, taking the physicality, but again, finding a way to knock down tough shots. It's not going to be easy. That zone has really been effective for Northwestern. And as I said, last possession, Brian McIntosh tugged on the jersey, said, I need a minute. And it's a great time to get it because then you have the under 12 timeout. And I bet he's in there for the long haul after that.
Smith also comes out. Frazier back in. Brown the miss. And now Allstor. Here's Jordan, and the nation's leading three-point shooter, adding to his great season.
That's the one problem. You cannot lose shooters, and when the ball reverses and the low man on the zone has to come out and take the wing, you got to be aware who's in the corner. Jordan had a wide open. He's looking.
His 20th made three of the year. Lindsey skying, hanging. It's knocked loose, and a foul will be called on Illinois.
Lindsey got bailed out. He was in a tough spot. He had nowhere to go with that. Got lucky with the foul.
It's on Kipper Nichols, his first.
Nothing wrong. If you're a good jump shooter like Scotty Lindsey, there's nothing wrong with pulling up from 15 feet.
Scotty Lindsey surprised that the foul was not called to the act of shooting. He was pleading with Paul Sells that I got a foul going up, and they say no.
He's going up, but he wasn't shooting that shot. Halfway under the basket.
Harden against Nichols. Pretty move there for Derek Harden. 6'8". Going up against 6'6".
He hasn't got many of those opportunities.
Allstor bumped along the baseline. And it'll be on Skelly. Let's go back to Scotty Lindsey, John, a moment ago.
Well, see if I was wrong again. I mean, he's going up. Initially, it looks like he's going to shoot it. I don't know. It's hard to say whether he's going to go back up to shoot that. I'm not in his mind. I'm not a mind reader. But the position he was in was not in a good spot to shoot the basketball.
Whistle, and with 12 minutes to go on the clock, that will take us to a timeout. Scotty Lindsey still upset that he wasn't at the free throw line. It's a one-point game on BTN. basketball on BTN is brought to you in part by State Farm. Here to help life go right. 47-46 Illinois. Exactly 12 to play in the ball game. Here tonight, the Illini all-time at Allstate Arena have lost only one time. That came back in 1984 to Loyola. Now, the last time Illinois was here, one of the more memorable games in college basketball history. Yeah. 2005 NCAA Tournament Elite Eight game, Illinois-Arizona. Illinois was down 15 with about 4 minutes to go in the game, and then D. Brown and Darren Williams and Luther Head and Roger Powell and James Augustine rallied to beat Arizona in overtime. And the Wildcats had a great team. Salim Stoudemire and Channing Frye and Hassan Adams. Hall of Famer Lute Olson coaching for Arizona. Bruce Weber, his second year for Illinois. Just a memorable game. Foul zone for three. That short. Nichols the rebound. Nichols couldn't finish against McIntosh. But Illinois, John, had not played a game here since that 0-5 Elite Eight win before tonight.
So far, so good. You got to give this team credit. They came into this season trying to establish an identity. So far, I think we're seeing it.
Near turnover, instead it's foul zone in traffic.
Different the offense is when it doesn't run through Brian McIntosh for Northwestern. When it runs through Brian McIntosh, good things happen.
I think he's begging for the ball. He had a mismatch inside against McIntosh, and now he's brought up top, and they switch back. There's that matchup again. Look at Finke, John. He's begging for it inside with six to shoot instead of deep three from Frazier, and there's Long with the rebound.
I don't know how you don't see that. And even if Michael Finke doesn't score, you've got to put pressure on Brian McIntosh to defend down there. Make him work as hard as possible on that defensive end.
Northwestern this half hit its first three shots from the field. Since then, three of its last 12.
Well, just having a tough time moving the ball right now.
Subs for both teams. Next whistle with three to shoot. Law got it off, and it's short, and all orange on the rebound. Halfway through, three-point game, and the Big Ten opener for both teams. Nichols, can he add on? No. And it belongs to Northwestern. Well, our experts break down the college football playoff picture on Big Ten Football and Beyond, Sunday at 1 Eastern, right here on BTN.
I'm so glad I don't have to debate football and who should be in, who should be out. Oh, my gosh, that's mind-numbing.
It's going to be a great game tomorrow night.
Oh,
Ohio State, Wisconsin.
It's just still funny. We have conference play on the basketball court and a football championship tomorrow. I think I heard Kevin Cooper mention that in their broadcast, Purdue-Maryland game. I basically plagiarize all the time. The rotation's defensive.
It'll count.
That was almost a terrific defensive play. I mean, great rotations, great closeout. The ball swung. But Brian McIntosh just being able to use that little ball fake. It's that little ball fake. They always say fake a pass to make a pass. Well, sometimes fake a pass to be able to execute something by getting into the lane. Brian McIntosh, a little small head fake, ball fake, and he's able to get into the paint and get that thing to go.
And that,
as I said, almost a great defensive possession.
And that bucket, John, that snapped a 2-minute, 25-minute segment of scoreless action, all sides.
A tie basketball game, man. This is what it's going to look like this year in the Big Ten. As I said, you know, Michigan State, Purdue, Maryland climbing up into that mix with Minnesota, the way they look tonight against Purdue. It's going to be wide open after that.
Lucas somehow got around and over Parton.
There's just an intensity to this Illini team. There's a fight. You know, they play hard.
Dijon Lucas with eight. stepped in, part, and got it deep and easily flushed it down.
This got extended, no ball pressure allowed the pass.
And now Lucas on the attack. And you see how quickly Illinois raced up the floor, and that's what they do.
Dijon Lucas with the basketball. A little bit of a magician. High wire act on the baseline, and then that. Look, that wasn't even bad ball pressure. I don't know what I'm talking about. That was just a fantastic pass from Brian McIntosh. Very few people can make that pass with their back to you. That was a terrific pass. With someone pressuring you.
Right, McIntosh is quickly approaching 600 career assists.
I don't have 600 career passes in high school and college.
Vicky.
That's ridiculous.
Now, Lindsey, great defense inside. Knocked it away. In the corner, long for the lead. And now Lucas on the push. Allstar trailing, catching, shooting. And long over everybody, the rebound.
If you don't have it, at some point, you got to get something good here for Northwestern. Get the ball back into Brian McIntosh's hands.
Kipper Nichols will check back in for the Illini next whistle. McIntosh underneath, doesn't go. Pardon there, ripped down and pulled away by Allstar. Lucas tripped and fouled. And that'll be on McIntosh, and we have a break here with 7:53. And the Big Ten opener all tied at 51.
Brian McIntosh, first half. This team struggled sharing the basketball with Brian McIntosh in the second half, doing a good job controlling the offense and creating opportunities for his teammates. As the defense extends, they're taking advantage of opportunities at the rim, but it's all because of Brian McIntosh and his ability to find teammates.
So Brian McIntosh for the game, 11 points, 5 assists, and we mentioned that he is approaching 600 now in his career all time. We mentioned Deron Williams and the 05 Illinois team. McIntosh has now surpassed him, 14th all time, 596, and a whole lot of basketball left this season for the talented senior from Greensburg, Indiana.
There's a couple ways you can beat pressure. Sometimes it's just driving, beat them to the basket. Other times it might be alleviate the pressure by back cutting. For Brian McIntosh, he's just making good passes.
Allstar bumped, and that's going to be on Skelly, and that'll be his fourth.
They're picking up fouls because they're just putting their heads down and getting to the basket. Dijon Lucas has been doing it in transition. It's hard to stop a guy with that kind of ball handling skill when he's just coming downhill.
Kevin Skelly will come out. Skelly, for the first time this season, did not start the game tonight. Neither he nor Scotty Lindsey started. Jordan Nash was in there. Falzone was in there to begin the game. And that had more to do with the five that competed in Atlanta against Georgia Tech. A second half run despite the one-point loss. Illinois regains the lead by two.
I love the physicality of Allstar. He really gets into the paint. A little bit of a shove, but not enough to get a foul. But he uses his body really well. And defensively, he's been tough on that side.
Announced that he would finish his career at Illinois in the spring, but did not officially arrive in Champaign till after finishing summer classes at Wright State. Northwestern's gone cold here. 2-point Illinois lead with 7:10 to play. Black against Jordan Nash and a foul. That's just a smart play there by LaRon Black, 6'7", backing down Jordan Nash at 6'3 and 200 pounds.
It's also important to mention it's smart of his teammates to stay out of his way. You start cutting and running to the basket, you're just bringing defense. Stay out of his way and let him work when he's got a mismatch.
17 foul now on Northwestern. Illinois has committed only 3. See the foul trouble the Wildcats have, and it's not a very deep team that Chris Collins has this season. First free throw attempts this half, and LaRon Black, a much improved free throw shooter. He's at 83% this season. LaRon Black last year was around 72%, but that's a part of his surge this year, how well he is shooting at the free throw line.
Of course, he's 5 of 10 tonight. Again, everything you say about foul shooting ruined. You ruined Brian McIntosh's streak.
20 in a row.
Oh, he's great. Well, he's shooting 20% tonight. 6 of 11. There you go.
That worked.
The key is
thank you, Laurent.
The key is he's getting to the foul. Yeah, that's something we can't say enough about. You have to be able to get to the foul. Find some comfort shooting basketball. It's a great find.
Lindsey against Williams. Spins, shoots, and scores. Lindsey with 15. Kind of a surprising 15 that Lindsey has on now three of, make it four of 13 shooting.
You're right. It's been a quiet 15, and he shot that thing with a lot of confidence.
And now the steal. Illinois got back. Kipper Nichols on the ground. Did he get a timeout, or was he on the baseline? He was out of bounds.
Scotty Lindsey just didn't really have the presence of mind in that moment to know that there's two defenders trailing the play. He's got three guys on at that point. Yeah, Kipper Nichols out of bounds there. Very close, really close, but slid out.
Neither team is led by more than 4 points this half. And play is halted before the inbounds pass. Illinois fans can be heard now.
Been heard the whole night.
McIntosh, the miss and a foul called on the Wildcats. And they're going to get Derek Hart. And some more free throws upcoming now for the Illini. It's the eighth team foul on Northwestern.
Three fouls against Illinois. It's hard to believe considering the amount of pressure they play with. I'm not saying it's unfair in any way. It's just they've been attacking. Illinois has been attacking and just forcing Northwestern to foul.
This is a 1-1 here for the graduate senior transfer, Mark Allstorff. Mentioned that he transferred from Wright State, but he began his collegiate career at Ball State.
Sure.
Dayton, Ohio.
Those grad transfers. I would love to have a grad transfer on my team because it brings a certain level of experience, but also a sense of urgency. Hey, guy, this is it. This is my last stop. Certainly going to make something, want to make something of it.
Our team's adding less JUCO transfers in lieu of more graduate senior transfers.
I don't think you do that in lieu of. I think you're going to take guys that help the team. And I think there is value in a guy that's got experience at a high level. Even if it's just for 1 year.
Aaron Jordan to foul about 25 feet from the basket. There's the fourth team foul now on the Illini, and the fourth foul on Aaron Jordan. So Skelly with four for the Wildcats, and now Jordan four, and he will come out. Nick Long, quiet half. McIntosh. Trapped. Hart maybe gave up a shot. McIntosh, a great look. Well, Harden passed up on one, and McIntosh had a great look. And it's a one-point game.
Well, that was a great find. You're going to give up a contested shot close to the basket for a wide-open three for Brian McIntosh. Great find.
McIntosh with 14. Lucas with five, floats, too strong. Nichols the tap, no, and Long the rebound. Couple of good looks. McIntosh, and he's bumped by Laron Black. And that'll be a foul.
Oftentimes when you double and you make a couple passes out of the double, both guys leave that man that you double. And that's exactly what happened with Brian McIntosh. Not good enough communication. Ended up leaving one of the best shooters on the floor wide open.
Brian McIntosh, you know, John, last year's three-point shooting percentage did drop quite a bit from where he was throughout his career, but it's back up to those numbers that he posted during his freshman and sophomore seasons. Meanwhile, Brad Underwood and Paul Sells having quite the debate, and a long leash there, and no technical foul called on the first-year Illinois coach, and now a foul will be whistled on the inbounds pass, and it's going to be on Finke.
these officials are used to that. Tom Izzo, Fran McCaffrey. They know how to take a little something from coaches and give them a little leash, too.
Third foul on Finke. Now the team foul is quickly piling up for Illinois, and this will go the other way as Finke hits the deck. And that's the ninth team foul now on the Wildcats, and it's going to be on foul zone.
Finke may have sold it, but I think foul zone did push off a little bit. It's going to be right side of your screen. Let's see. He's going to lean into him. Yeah, he sold it.
That's foul zone's fourth, so he and Skelly with four, and foul zone comes out.
I wouldn't have called that one. This is good, though, man. This is intense.
Skelly back on the floor with those four fouls. Allstore penetrating, lays it up and in. A veteran move by Allstore. Illinois by three. And now Williams got away with the first bump, but not the second time. So Demonte Williams, the freshman, picks up the foul. We have a ball game, folks. 4:23 to play, a three-point game. Subscribe now to BTN Plus to gain access to hundreds of non-televised games, including men's basketball. The pass is starting at $9.95 per month. See your school in action and never miss a moment of the excitement. Get BTN Plus available on BTN to go with John Crisp and Corey Provis from Rosemont, Illinois. Here at the Allstate Arena. Big Ten opener, two longtime rivals, the 175th all-time meeting, Illinois and Northwestern. It's a one-possession game with 4:23 to play in regulation. McIntosh, 14 points. Long, quiet second half, bothered by Allstore. And now a foul. With 11 to shoot. Going to be on Allstore. It's his second.
Northwestern shooting 1-1. That was a clear out. I had to pause a little bit because I wanted to say clear out. That was a clear ISO opportunity, excuse me, for Vic Wall. And opportunity to get to the foul line, too. You got to make these things count.
It's a 1-1 situation, and Law buries it. Both teams have shot the ball well from the free throw line tonight. Over 80% on both sides. Aaron Jordan, four fouls, returns.
It was almost great defense by Allstore, who's been fantastic tonight. But when you have space like that to work, it does give the advantage to the offensive player.
Is cut off by Part, reverses dribble, and Part of the block. Tremendous footwork, and then the extension. Part in with the block on Lucas. Skelly lost it. Illinois has led since the 7:41 mark. The bounce, Lindsey for the lead. Lindsey was 17, 10 of those coming here in the half, and a blocking foul on Skelly, and that's number five.
It's number five, and it's completely unnecessary. Can't lose that momentum, Corey. This is a battle. Big Ten Conference play started up December 1st. It's going to be a grinder.
Pretty far off campus, but Northwestern providing a shuttle and some food vouchers for the students. Taking the games here. Hey, we'll take whatever they can get, right?
Whatever it takes. Did that food voucher buy that 40-ounce whatever that guy was drinking?
1-point game. Chris Collins has seen Gavin Skelly foul out. And two free throws the rest of the way for the Illini. Two shots here for Tijon Lucas. 9 of 12 at the line. On the season.
Haven't seen a lot of Mark Smith either. It's been interesting. This is an Illini team that has a little more depth than anybody realizes.
Mark Smith, 5 points, 8 minutes. Foul trouble early in this game. And who knows if Smith doesn't pick up, but two fouls the first 2 minutes of the game, maybe things play out differently for the talented freshman, but much a non-factor for now.
He's going to be fine. I wouldn't call him a non-factor. I mean, look, when he's in there, he's making plays. He's hitting shots. I just think he can go with what's working.
Long, good look for the lead. Against Pardon. Big against big, and a foul. Get an arm bar on Pardon. And that'll be his third, John.
That's where you gotta learn how to body and gap. Body up when he's leaning into you, and then gap to be able to control that space. When he puts the ball on the floor, you cannot ride alongside of him. You gotta be able to gap, beat him to the spot.
See the numbers on LeRon Black at the free throw line, and he is now 3 of 3. Pardon picking up his third. Let's go back to the foul.
You've got to be able to use your length. You cannot ride the body. You're going to get called for that every single time. You've got to be able to space, use your length to take a shot away.
Timeout called by the Illini. Tied for the 9th time here tonight. 63 with 2:46 to play. Illinois in the second half. It's been Mark Allstor, the graduate senior transfer, John.
Yeah, man, I love the physicality of Mark Allstor. I mean, if you look at him, if you watch him in between plays, he's kind of mixing it up. He's getting his body into people. He's getting to the basket. He finishes well. But he's also been great defensively. He's played great defense on Brian McIntosh. And they do switch from time to time. So he's had to take on a number of different challenges, including Scotty Lindsey and Vic Law.
First game tonight here on BTN. Purdue winning by 5 in Maryland in the nightcap. All tied at 63, 2:46 to play. Conference action beginning. 5 days of coverage here on BTN. And a little break before things begin in earnest come 2018.
I think during that break, there's going to be some teams that have to regroup and figure out what they need to correct when the bulk of the conference schedule picks up.
McIntosh throws it away. McIntosh committing his third turnover alone tonight.
That was great help defense. You got to look at the help side defense. They came down and collapsed so quickly, it forced Bryant McIntosh to jump out of bounds to make that pass. Really had nowhere to go.
Does Illinois go back to LeRon Black here inside?
Here it goes.
Allstor's looking for him. Cut off by Lindsey and calls a timeout. Illinois will have one timeout remaining. And Derek, we'll keep it here with 2:18 to play.
Derek Pardon did the job of playing defense early. You see that so often that once an offensive player gets positioned on you, your feet, especially when you've got foul issues, you're dealing with a guy like LeRon Black who's quicker than Derek Pardon. So Derek Pardon worked early defensively and took that opportunity away.
See, Chris Collins has his team over coming up for Northwestern, their second game of this opening sequence of Big Ten play. It'll be tough going to Mackey on Sunday. You'll be there for that one.
I'll be there for the Valpo game as well back here. It's a team that, again, really have not seen them play to the best of their ability. They haven't lived up to expectations as of yet. Doesn't mean they're not going to. I still think top to bottom it could be an NCAA tournament team. But you've got to play with that sense of urgency, that purpose that they had last year. You've got to find a way to muster up that energy.
So also still to come for Chris Collins at DePaul, but DePaul no longer plays here. They opened up a brand new facility in the city before this season began. Seven to shoot. Nichols off the glass. Fell down. No whistle. And now the Wildcats.
That was rich.
And McIntosh throws it away again. Boy, Northwestern missed a chance inside.
Yeah, well, they missed a chance, but it was great helpside defense. They stayed in position. The backside of the defense stayed home, which took away any pass over the top into the paint.
Back-to-back turnovers on McIntosh.
Just consistently forced Brian McIntosh into bad situations.
Lucas leaves it for Jordan. Laron Black against two Wildcat defenders, Law and Pardon. They're tangled up, and a jump ball is the call. The arrow will stick with the Illini.
Vic Law just mistimed his jump, just a split second. That's how Laron Black was able to get in on it and tie it up.
Brad Underwood, his first game as a Big Ten head coach, at least in a conference game. Ball falls down, but he's back up on his feet. Finke working against foul zone, and Jordan had the ball ripped away, and now a jump is called again. This time it'll belong to the Wildcats.
It's not good offense, but you have to commend the defense. They look to get the ball inside, first on the opposite side with Laron Black, and then Michael Finke working hard, but the defender's working even harder, taking it away, and then Jordan just kind of getting himself in a tough position. This is where you learn a little something about your team. These tight matchups, 63-63, a minute 11 left. And it's not just who's going to make a big shot. Who's going to get a big stop?
You saw the duo there defensively collapse on Jordan. It was foul zone. It was Law. You go back to the winning play, Georgia Tech and Todrick Jackson.
Yeah.
He got around or between those two defenders for the game-winning basket.
Yeah, just miscommunication and tough way to lose. Tough way to lose a game where you defend well.
Under a minute to play. Foul zone. Tipped. Allstort to steal. Another Northwestern turnover. Three straight trips. Three straight turnovers.
Oh, there's more trust in Brian McIntosh, but foul zone just got himself in a bad spot.
Rosemont all you. Can hold for the final shot.
Here he is. He really was never set up for a screen, but he just got in the way, and that's where the foul's going to be called. It's the right call. Again, not an offensive foul on Allstort. That was on Laron Black.
Brad Underwood pacing in front of his bench. Shot clock is off. Northwestern, after losing at the buzzer on Tuesday night, has a chance to win it in its final possession. Full court pressure. Well done by the Illini. Vic Law has to call a timeout, so both teams have one remaining.
Look, after the way Northwestern lost to Georgia Tech, I mean, this is where you've got to be able to execute down the stretch. It's been how many? Three consecutive turnovers for Northwestern. But you've got to be happy if you're Chris Collins and your ability to get a stop to lock down defensively.
And think about the bucket that put Northwestern briefly ahead on Tuesday night. It was a missed three from foul zone. Pardon had the putback. Yeah. But now Chris Collins has a chance to draw up something. It must begin with number 30, right?
Oh, absolutely. It always does. You just got to find a way to give him some space. I don't think you give him a ball screen. I think you give him space to work. And if the defense converges to the paint, then you got to trust Brian McIntosh to find the right guy. You got to do it with just enough time to be able to make an extra pass and get a shot. Coming along with playing for overtime, too.
just don't want to give Illinois a chance to get a rebound and get something going the other way.
No fouls to give either.
Oh, that was given up a long time ago.
Let's take a look at our Duluth Trading hardest working player we focus on. The senior from Hillside, Illinois, Scotty Lindsey. He's had a good second half, 17 points in all 10 of the 17 coming in the second half. Just 5 of 14 shooting, but 17 for Lindsey. McIntosh, 14. Law has 16. As the Wildcats will break the huddle, it's Law, McIntosh, Pardon, foul zone, Lindsey, the Illini countering with Lucas, Finke, Allstor, Black, and Devontae Williams.
I still think you got to just create space. Give space for Bryant McIntosh to work. No reason to send the ball screen his way and bring another defender.
Northwestern with one timeout left. Final 15. McIntosh with six. McIntosh going, lost it. Deflected. Laron Black lets it go from half court. Short, and we play on. Getting a piece of the nylon. But the Wildcats, four straight possessions, four straight turnovers. Black a half court heave that fell shy. And we have more basketball coming up here from Allstate Arena.
I still feel like Bryant McIntosh needs more space to work with. And when you bring the ball screen, it forces him higher around the top. Here you're going to see forced higher over the top. It brings him into another defender, and he's got no room to work. I would just trust Bryant McIntosh to make the play. And look how close this thing comes.
Wow. Piece of the rim. You know, go back to McIntosh, too. And you were in this spot, I'm sure, a few times as a player. You know, McIntosh, he began to move. He began to drive with about 5 seconds, maybe just under six. Did he wait too long to create there? Or was that about right, the time?
That's about right. If that's what you're trying to do, get him to get something going to the basket, you need just enough time where defense converges, you can kick out for an open shot. But you don't want to give Illinois any time to get something good. They get that ball with 3 more seconds, they may get something better at the rim.
Boy, Northwestern down the stretch. They had a few chances, but constant trips, John, and it was constant turnovers.
Yeah, it's constant turnovers, but it's been good defense. And this is a defense that put this Northwestern team in tough positions. You can't think you're getting into the paint. You think you got a driving lane, but it all converges. They don't overhelp. They read things well defensively. But a very well-coached team, Illinois.
All. Illinois led by four at halftime. It's been a better played second half. Wouldn't you agree? The first half was sluggish. We saw turnovers and fouls and poor shooting, but better basketball. Cleaner basketball
absolutely.
In the second 20.
Cleaner basketball team settled in, and that happens. That happens with a young team. It happens with an old team. It doesn't matter. And Northwestern settled in a bit in that second half. They used the zone to get control of the tempo and the pace of the game, and I think that certainly helped. I'm wondering if they get back into that zone at this point to at least control the pace of the next 5 minutes of play.
See, the turnover number is awfully high. Both of those coming, though, both teams more in the first half. Both teams have shot the ball well at the free throw line. Pardon and Finke will jump. Overtime between Illinois and Northwestern, and Laron Black will hand it off to Tijon Lucas. Mark Smith remains on the bench. Devontae Williams begins this overtime period for the Illini. Lucas with seven. Lucas in trouble. Black has to let it go with three. Off the mark, and great position for Lindsey inside the rebound.
They're doing a great job with that ball screen. Whether they're hedging hard or playing it flat, forcing Bryant McIntosh over the top, they're not giving him the easy lane.
The floater doesn't go, and Allstor, he's had a good second half. Or had a good second half. He flies in for the rebound. His sixth rebound tonight. And now he turned it over.
I
feel like the carry's a call you can make on every other play down the floor. I see so many carries in basketball, but when it gives you an advantage, yeah, that's a carry.
Right in front of Terry Weimer. Williams was defending McIntosh a moment ago, and now he picks up Lindsey. Lindsey, though, breaks it, and Williams the rebound.
I mean, this Illinois defense is just forcing tough shots. Forcing contested shots, whether it be at the rim or 15 feet away, everything's contested.
Wildcats now six straight empty trips down the floor. Finke flashing and fouled. And two free throws upcoming, and if that's on par, that's going to be number four. And else they're going to say foul zone. Now we've got some pushing and shoving inside, and Terry Weimer is going to try to get control of this.
I think he may have just got Vic Law a technical foul.
So Vic Law being ushered back towards his bench, and now the officials will meet. So a couple things to sort out here. First, the personal foul, then the skirmish. So Aaron Falzone, it's on the fifth foul on Aaron Falzone before Terry Weimer blew his whistle. And so Vic Law and LaRon Black whistled for a double technical foul by Terry Weimer. So Falzone, five fouls. That won't change. He is done for the night. And now the officials meeting to sort out the technical foul or fouls that were whistled a moment ago from Terry Weimer.
You would want from an experienced team, especially here at Northwestern, is you're going to be able to keep your composure. Yes, you want to fight. Yes, you want to establish your toughness. But at the same time, you need to be under control and finish this game.
All right, Terry Weimer is going to come over and chat with John. And if the call stands, technical foul also will be a personal foul on both players. So that would be Law's fourth and LaRon Black's fourth personal foul as well. And now we will find out.
Offsetting technical fouls on Vic Law, number four, and LaRon Black. There might be some words in there that, if you're a lip reader, you might be able to make sense of. It's just Terry Weimer trying to get control of this game.
So two free throws. This is unrelated to the technical fouls that were called a moment ago. But two free throws here for Michael Finke. One of two at the line tonight, and the first one falls. Now, Finke, a year ago, they see foul zone dump of the night. He and Gavin Skelly have fouled out. You know, Finke doesn't shoot a ton of free throws. And at least last year, John, he was more reliant on the three-point shot. And despite his size, he's a good three-point shooter, but doesn't get to the free throw line too often.
That's just not really how he plays. He has been working to get the ball in the post, though, tonight. And I think there's going to be certain matchups that he can exploit.
Isaiah Brown back in with foul zone done. Williams the strip on McIntosh. The freshman pushing. And now stopping. Lucas, a huge three. And Brown the rebound.
Just not enough space for Northwestern to work. Brian McIntosh can't get into the paint. Scotty Lindsey lines one up.
Lindsey with 20. Stoneface Barrett Benson watching that one fall. That snaps a stretch of seven straight empty trips for the Wildcats. Lucas in trouble. Too hot for Black. Out of bounds. It'll stay with Illinois.
That's a big shot from Scotty Lindsey, but what's even bigger is just the willingness to take it. Yes, Chris Collins gives them the confidence to shoot that shot in transition. Transition three, sometimes the best shot you're going to get in 30 seconds, especially against this Illini defense. But he shot that with confidence. And, and defensively, Northwestern has really locked up.
No real argument about who last touched that ball. But a rule that I'm not a big fan of. Much like in regulation, out of possession, it's only 2 minutes or less remaining in the game. In overtime, that situation still stands. Why not in overtime?
I would check everything.
But only the last 2 minutes. Tajon Lucas, the sophomore from Milwaukee.
Jordan Nash just checked into the game, and you get beat. That's the one thing you can't do is get beat to the basket.
Tajon Lucas now with 12. Tied at 66, two to play. Lindsey, too strong. Black the rebound.
It's not there. It's just not there.
Our 10th tie tonight. Can Lucas change that? That won't count. Paul Sell is going to wave off the basket, and the foul occurred on the ground. And if that's Vic Law, he's done. And that is number 5 on Vic Law, the third Northwestern player to foul out tonight.
I tell you, it is next to impossible to slow down Tajon Lucas when he's coming downhill. He does a great job of protecting the ball, kind of cradles it like a football when he's going through traffic. And here it is. Look, he's just going to cradle that ball. Not a lot there. They're going to get him on the hit.
And remember the technical foul.
Yep,
the technical foul. The double tech added a personal foul to Law's line tonight. That was his 4th on the technical. Now he's done.
Yeah, look, I like the guys that compete. I like the guys that got fire. And Vic Law certainly got that. But when it comes down to it, you've got to put yourself in a position to be on the floor when it counts. Minute 49, overtime, 66 all. Yeah, it counts. Now, man, I tell you, he could do some special things offensively and defensively. It's going to be tough to close this thing out with him on the bench.
Two shots here for Tajon Lucas. 2 of 2 at the line.
I think rebounding is where you really miss Vic Law the most right now. He's a guy who really goes up and gets rebounds.
Jordan Nash comes in as Law sits. And now Devontae Williams will check back in for Illinois. Michael Finke out. Now foul trouble for Illinois. LaRon Black 4, Aaron Jordan 4.
LaRon Black, technical foul as well.
And both Black and Jordan are on the floor right now for Illinois. Empty trip there for Lucas. He misses 2. McIntosh, 14 points, but 6 turnovers. Brown shooting over Black, and how about that shot for the sophomore from Seattle? Was a big-time scorer in high school, and the Wildcats lead by 2. Lucas got it off the glass. Sophomore to sophomore on both ends. It was Brown, and now it's Lucas. And a timeout call with 1:15 to play in OT.
Look, at this point, a big shot's got to be followed by a big stop. But Tajon Lucas is just willing his way to the basket. Isaiah Brown, you said it. He was a big scorer in high school, so he's not afraid to take this shot. Again, yeah, fantastic defense. Not an easy look. Contested jump shot. But on the other end, Tajon Lucas, again, just wills his way to the basket. I don't know how he got this shot up. I was surprised Derek Hart didn't get a piece of it. Keeping his team in this game. It's fantastic basketball. I mean, I should say fantastic basketball. It hasn't been pretty the whole night, but type of intensity that you're seeing December 1st, you just don't often get.
Tajon Lucas tonight, he has had a guy averaging 5 points per game a year ago. He averaged 5 and 4 assists in 15 minutes. But Tajon Lucas, as we mentioned, a point guard, more of the traditional makeup, pass first, score second, but not tonight. And the 14 is a new career high for Tajon Lucas.
Well, the best point guard is the one that does whatever his team needs him to do. And that's what he's doing tonight.
See the guys who have fouled out for Northwestern. A minute to play. Lindsey stripped and fouled. All-star Daddy at all ball. And that'll be the 3rd foul on All-star. And free throws upcoming here for Scotty Lindsey.
I'm
going to see it on the spin. I thought Allstark was in position to make the play. This is good defense so far. That's a lot of ball. That's a lot of ball.
So Lindsey's shooting two. 79% of the year. And now 6 of 7 at the line tonight is the senior from Hillside, Illinois. Lindsey up to 21 points. 14 of the 21 have come since halftime.
I don't want to take anything away from Northwestern, but I think the expectations for Northwestern are there. I'm impressed with Illinois. I'm really impressed with the Illini right now. I think there's depth there. You can go 9 deep strong. And again, Mark Smith, one of your best players. Limited minutes tonight, and you're still getting production.
Jordan Ash slapping the floor. Fans on both sides on their feet for the final 50. Allstark for the tie was blocked, recovered by Gaines. And Lucas and McIntosh tangled up and a timeout called by Northwestern.
Now, I don't think they initially wanted that timeout. I think they were going to play it out. But when Brian McIntosh lost the ball, had to pick it up. Now, the key now is Illinois has an opportunity for a steal. See, when he sees Brian McIntosh is in trouble, he wants that timeout. But this is a unique opportunity for Illinois as well. I mean, part of the reason why you don't call that timeout is you trust the guy that has the ball in his hands to make a play. You trust him to do something, but now Illinois has a chance to pressure and maybe get a turnover, get something back at the other end. And remember, this is an Illinois team that their staple, their new identity is pressure defense. They don't just pressure you in the half court. They don't even want to let you get the ball in bounds. They don't just try to stop your out-of-bounds play underneath. They try to keep you from even inbounding the ball. So this is going to be a challenge, just getting the ball inbounds.
A game that has seen 8 lead changes. Second half overtime alone, 7 lead changes. Shot clock at 10, game clock at 24. McIntosh with 4. McIntosh, big shot. Doesn't go. Jordan the rebound. Shot clock is off. Illinois has a timeout if it wants it. Lucas with 8. The crossover with 5. It's blocked by Pardon. Picked up by Brown. And he's fouled with 2.1 to play in OT.
Tijon Lucas has been fantastic this game. But at that moment, I think he's just trying to win the game in one play. Derek Pardon, good job giving enough space to not pick up that foul.
So 2 free throws upcoming for Isaiah Brown, who hasn't missed the free throw line this season. 6 of 6. Tijon Lucas getting some coaching, encouraging words right now from Brad Underwood.
Corey, let me tell you, this game's not over yet, but you're learning a lot about these two teams. Not only are you learning a lot about these two teams, I think you're learning a lot about how competitive this season's going to be in the Big Ten. Like I said before, I think you got Michigan State, Minnesota, and Purdue up at the top. But after that, I do feel like it is wide open. And these are all teams that can beat Michigan State, Minnesota, or Purdue. But this is going to be a competitive season. You're going to see a lot of hard-fought games like this.
I'm excited for Big Ten play. Oh, look at the 2 games we've had tonight here on BTN. Purdue winning by 5 in Maryland. This one in overtime. So 2.1 to play. Isaiah Brown in line shooting 2. Updating his free throw numbers. He's 1 of 2 tonight. So now 7 of 8 on the year. He is Isaiah Brown.
Seeing a little extra fight in Northwestern. And this is one, if they're able to close this thing out, there's still 2 seconds left.
Illinois does not have a timeout. Western with 1. Isaiah Brown even before the season began, he suffered a quad injury. And that has impacted his play. Still not at 100%. And now this one should seal it. And now it begs the question, too, if he misses it. Illinois without a timeout. Is Northwestern foul?
You don't foul, not on this side of the court. Maybe on the other side of the court, but I would not on this side of the court.
It's a new point. Isaiah Brown steps up. 4 points in overtime for Isaiah Brown, and all four coming since that man fouled out at Vic Law.
Vic Law fouled out. That definitely hurt them, but at the same time, Vic Law had a fantastic game. That man works. And there's an intensity to him that I think they've been missing since Sanjay Lumpkin left campus. Talked about that with Chris Collins. Sanjay Lumpkin is the heart and soul of this team, that glue guy, X-Factor, whatever you want to call him. And I think we're going to find out who that's got to be this year. And if you're a Northwestern student, take the bus, take the train, carpool, Uber, Lyft, whatever your choice is. Get out here, man.
Food vouchers.
Food vouchers. Come on. Eat some free popcorn. That stuff costs like $10 everywhere else.
Big Show coming up next. Right after we're done here. It's a shame these two teams are only meeting one time in the regular season. But that'll change next year.
It's a shame because this is an experienced Northwestern team that you're not going to see next year. And I think it's going to be a completely different Illini team. This is a team with a lot of upside.
Lucas can't hit, and in overtime, Northwestern knocks off its longtime rival, 72-68. Vic Law fouled out for Brian McIntosh, and his Wildcats found a way. McIntosh, 6 turnovers. Chris Collins wins his Big Ten opener as the Wildcats win 72-68. That'll do it from here, from the Allstate Arena. Again, the final score in overtime. Northwestern 72, Illinois 68. For John Crispin, Corey Provis saying so long. We hope you've enjoyed it. We've had a blast here bringing this one to you. Stay tuned. The Big Show is coming up next, right here on BTN.